الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our siyam, our dua, and our qiyam. Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to correct our intentions in this great month and to reshape and revive our iman, inshaAllah ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the increase of piety and righteousness that will be with us the rest of the year, not only in Ramadan. Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen. The greatest element that will help all of us to be on the path, to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are two things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave his last will to take care of them. These are the Qur'an and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Qur'an and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the translation of the Qur'an into our life. And the Qur'an, as we'll be reading it in this great month, also to travel within the Qur'an, to try to bring the values of the Qur'an in our life, to implement the values of the Qur'an in our daily life, and to make ourselves behave in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith, a narration, said, تَخَلَّقُ بِأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. Have your moral, your character based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us, on the attributes of Allah, on the names of Allah. Allah is Arhamur Rahimeen. Allah is the most merciful. We need to have mercy. Allah is the most kind. We need to have kindness. Allah is the most generous. We need to be generous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ghayur. He has jealousy toward his deen. We have to do that. We have to have our love to our deen, our love to our iman, to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on everything he gave us. And the highest priority of this great provision is our iman, will make our identity. This iman, this is the great thing that we have. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep showering us and bestowing on us his gift subhanahu wa ta'ala to always increase iman, to revive our iman, to refresh our iman. And we are in the great season of the refreshment and the revival of the iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide that the taqwa. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's the one who give you the gift? If you're looking for khushu' in the salah, you cannot find it in the market. You cannot find it inside the book. You cannot find it in a show. The khushu' in the salat is in the hand of Allah. Come willingly to Allah. Come humble to Allah. Allah will give you the khushu'. If you want the taqwa, the same thing. If you want to be humble, the same thing. All these good things are there stored in the hand of Allah. Allah will give it to you when you feel the need that you want it. Yesterday we were talking about the need for the forgiveness. If you don't have this need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how are you going to have the presence of your heart, in your heart, of asking Allah, forgive me? When you are in a sujood and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh, forgive me, without the need in your heart, you're not gonna feel it yourself. That's why Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, seeing someone asking forgiveness in the masjid, he said, your istighfar require another istighfar. The way that you ask Allah forgiveness indeed require to you ask Allah to forgive you for this way you are asking him. Because there is no those great etiquette, those being humble and humiliated to Allah and feeling the need, ya Allah, if you don't forgive me, we are lost, ya Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the two words or the sentence that Allah mentioned and he taught to Adam and Hawa, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. What are these words? Because Adam, when he was expelled from the Jannah for 40 years, in some narration, he's in tears waiting how Allah will forgive him. For 40 years. If Allah would not forgive us, we don't have any way to go. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Takwir, فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. Where are you going to go? If there's any earth belongs to any other god, someone will travel for it, but there is nothing. Everything belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. Where are you going to go? Adam alayhi salam waiting all these years to receive the blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how he going to ask forgiveness, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive him. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتِ. These words are the greatest gift that Allah gave to Adam and to his own offspring. And Allah mentioned in Surah Al-A'raf, قَالَ رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Allah, we transgress ourselves. And if you do not forgive us and shower us with your mercy, we are in utter loss. We are the losers. So he's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his greatness, his blessing, that he subhanahu wa ta'ala will to forgive you. If he will not, we are lost. Because you can pray 1,000 years, who's telling you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to accept your salah? Well, that's what we need, that inkisar, humiliation to Allah, to come begging him subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our deeds. Because in a hadith narrated by Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, if Allah will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he will accept one sajda from you, you will be in paradise. One sajda. It's like someone he's looking forward to have that deep sajda, like the sajda of the sorcerer of Fir'aun, the magician that we mentioned yesterday. One sajda makes them to be elevated in the ranks of the righteous. And we were mentioning about Urwa ibn Zubayr. He asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was wishing to be a scholar. And he is like a young man running in the street of Medina looking for the companion Ridwanullah ta'ala alayhim to learn from them. And he learned from a Sayyid Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and he became one of the greatest scholars of Medina, one of the 7 great tabi'in, Urwa ibn Zubayr. He was traveling, subhanallah, and this is the situation of every believer. He was traveling with his son to go to Asham visiting Al-Khalifa. When he got there, they get into place, and his son went out to play. Went out to play. Get on the top of the house, he fell, and when he fell, he came around, you know, animals. They step on the kid, and the son died. They brought the son to Urwa, his son dead. قَالَ إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We need to understand those trials that we encounter every day. We said, it might be good for you. It might be a reminder for us. It might be for us to shake us, to wake up. But all the time we need to be grateful to Allah. Because Allah, to Him belong what He gave you and what He took. So Urwa ibn Zubayr given us an example, because the sorcerer facing Fir'aun, and they gave their life for the deen of Allah. They gave for their life for saying, آمَنَّ بِرَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ. We believe in the Lord of Musa and Harun. Urwa here in another situation, like us, believer, living, and he's a great scholar, a lot of student, great pious, one of the greatest pious of the tabi'in. Having this son close to his heart that he took in this journey, dead on the spot. قَالَ إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Then subhanAllah, in the same journey, he has a pain in his foot. When they checked, they have what we call akala, something that eating is inside like a virus. And they found that they need to cut his leg. The son dead, and the leg is going to be shot. Now the doctor, he told him, we need to, in a way, to give you something so you would not feel it. But at the time that he didn't have this technology of today, so the thing that they need to use, muskirat, alcohol things. So he has to drink, so he will be faint or get drunk in a way so they can do such a thing. قَالَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. I will not do that. How come I will allow myself to be distracted from the dhikr of Allah? They said, but we need to do that. He said, when I get into the salah, you can do your job. When I get into the salah, to link between the magician and Urwa, the deep sujood. The deep sujood. And he, when he was in sujood with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they cut the leg of Urwa. When he stood from the sujood, seeing the blood, he fainted. But in the sujood, he was with Allah. May Allah to grant us this khushu' in sujood. Urwa ibn Zubayr has his leg been cut into sujood. Into sujood. And then after he fainted, when he woke up, they came to him, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me 4 children. He get one, he took one, and he left me 3. MashaAllah, alhamdulillah. لَإِنْ أَخَذَ فَقَدْ أَبْقَى. And he gave me 4 lirs. He took one and he left me 3. لَإِنْ أَخَذَ فَقَدْ أَبْقَى وَلَإِنِ ابْتَلَى فَقَدْ عَافَى. If he took, Allah, he already left me a lot. And if he put me in trial, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he showered me with his blessing. Urwa went back to Al-Madinah. And you see him with one leg and he's still teaching. But the most amazing thing, Urwa never missed Salatul Jama'ah. They told him, you are Urwa, you have an excuse. Why you come? He said, how I hear Hayya ala Salat and don't come? How do you want me to hear Hayya ala Salat and don't come to the house of Allah? He told them, if you don't see me in the masjid in the first line, know that Urwa is already in the grave. These are khiriji, those students from the Prophethood University. Tabi'i, as we said, he's his mother Asma and his father is Urwa ibn Zubayr, or Zubayr ibn al-Awwal. And there's a lot of examples. To say in the salah is not to use the salah in the way like Urwa, he used it. But the question mark, how can we understand the khushu'ah that Urwa had in his sujood? Ya Allah, how someone cannot even feel what type of sujood? It is a fiction, it is an illusion, it is a reality. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, for normal people, if someone is totally taken away from certain beauty he's watching, all his senses becomes numb. He cannot even feel anything. When someone was explaining, and he's saying how he read hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the shaheed, when he died, he doesn't feel anything. He said, how this is can happen? So they told him, it's in the book of Allah. He tried to look in the book of Allah to find where to find this. And he said, after I read the Quran, I found it in Surah Yusuf. When Yusuf alayhi salam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided him the half of the beauty of the humankind. قَالَتْ اِخْرُجْ عَلَيْهِمْ. She said, امْرَأَةُ الْعَزِيزِ, come out. When they saw him, they were fully attracted with his beauty. They become numbs. قَطَّعْنَ أَيْدِيَهُنْ. They cut their hands without even feeling. So the man, he said, subhanallah, if these normal people seeing the beauty of a created, so what do you think of a believer seeing the beauty of Allah? You will not feel anything. قَطَّعْنَا أَيْدِيَهُنَّ. They cut their hands watching the beauty of a created human being. So what do you think if you come to level to look and see with your heart the beauty of Allah? That's what Urwa was feeling in the sujood. And many of other Sahaba will bring you tomorrow, inshaAllah, another example of Ubadah ibn Bashr. amazing way of khushu in the salat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the khushu, to increase our iman and have our path or steps to be firm on the way of Allah. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana ajma'in wa tub alayna ya rabbal alamin. Wa ila salati yarhamukum Allah.